Hi guys, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create a macOS bootable USB installer using a Windows PC, even if you don't have access to a Mac right now. It's super handy when your Mac needs a clean install or recovery. And we'll walk through every step in a beginner-friendly way. So grab a USB drive and let's get started. What you need before we begin: a USB drive with at least 16 GB of space, a macOS DMG file for the version you want to install, a tool called TransMac, a Windows PC with internet access. First, we need to check if your USB drive is already using the GPT partition style or not, because GPT is required for macOS to detect and boot from the USB. If your USB is using the older MBR format, you will need to convert it to a GPT first. Okay, so don't worry, I will show you how. So let's start by checking the current partition style. Okay, so plug the USB drive into the PC, then right click on this PC and go to manage. Then select disk management and look for your USB drive in the bottom list. So then right click on the disk number level and click on properties. Then go to the volume tab. Here you will see a partition style. It will either say GUID partition style, that is GPT, or master boot record MBR. If your USB drive already shows GPT, you can skip the next conversion part and move on to the formatting or creating the partition. But if it says MBR, you need to convert it to GPT first. So for that, open command prompt as administrator, and here you need to type Diskpart and hit enter and wait for the Diskpart prompt to appear. Then type list disks and hit enter. This will show all disks connected to your PC. Look carefully and identify your USB drive based on its size. In my case, you can see it's disk 2. So now select your disks. That means you need to type select disk 2 and hit enter. After that, you need to type clean and hit enter. And it says Diskpart succeeded in cleaning the disk. Now you need to type convert GPT and hit enter. When I ran this command, I got this message: the disk you specified is not MBR formatted. Please select an empty MBR disk to convert. That simply means my USB drive was already in GPT format, so no need to convert it again. If your disk was MBR, you would see a message like disk successfully converted to GPT. So once it done, now let's create a partition. Type create partition primary and hit enter. And you are done. Your USB drive is now using GPT format and ready for the next step. So type exit. Now we need the installer images for macOS, which we'll use to create the bootable USB. So we are going to use a trusted website called archive.org. to get the macOS installer. Okay, so don't worry, I have added the direct link in the video description below for your convenience. Once you are on the page, here you will get all macOS images. See, now look to the right hand side and you will see a section called macOS X disk images. Click on that and inside you will find DMG files of all macOS version, including the macOS Sonoma, Ventura, Monterey, Big Sur and Catalina. Here, you need to keep one thing in mind: that your Mac cannot boot from a macOS installer that's older than the version it originally came with. For example, if your Mac came with a macOS Big Sur, then it won't boot from the older version like Sierra. In that case, you should go with the Big Sur, Monterey, Ventura or Sonoma. Any version that's the same or newer. Okay. In my case, I am going to download macOS Sonoma 14. So just click on the Sonoma DMG file and the download will start immediately. As you can see, the file is almost 14 GB in size. So make sure you have enough space and give it some time to download. Okay, once it downloaded, we will move on to the next step and create a bootable USB using the image. Okay, to create the macOS bootable USB, we will use a very helpful tool called TransMac. It allows us to restore DMG file to a USB drive on Windows, which is normally not possible with the regular tools. Okay, so open your browser and simply type download TransMac in the search bar And from the search result, click on this web official site. Don't worry, the direct link is already given in the description below for your convenience. So once the page is open, look for a file called tmsetup.zip. Click on it to start downloading. This is the zip file and it's quite small, so the download should complete very quickly. As you can see on the websites, it's clearly mentioned that TransMac is a paid software, but it offers a 15 days free trial, which is more than enough for our task. So no need to worry, we won't need to pay anything just to create our bootable USB over here. Once the zip file is downloaded, you need to unzip the file using any zip tool, okay? Once you unzip, go to the inside of the folder and you will find a file name setup.exe. Just double click on that to start the installation. And here you need to follow the on-screen instruction. It's a basic installation, so just keep clicking next until it's done. After installation, you need to run TransMac as administrator. So right click on the icon and run as administrator. And wait for a few seconds and click on run to continue. Use this trial version. Once it open, your USB will appear in the left hand panel. Now here come the main step. Just right click on your USB drive inside the TransMac and here you need to choose restore with Dix images. Then click yes to confirm. Now click browse and select the macOS DMG file you downloaded earlier. Then click OK to start. And here you need to again click on OK. This process will take some time depending on your USB speed and the size of the DMG file. Usually it takes almost 15 to 30 minutes. Okay, so you need to wait until it finishes. When it's done, you will see a completion message. Now close this window and safely eject the USB from your Windows PC. Now plug it into the Mac you want to install macOS on. And if you have an Apple M series Mac, press and hold the power button until you see the loading startup option screen. Then just choose the macOS installer from the boot options and begin the installation process. So guys, that's how you create a macOS bootable USB drive using just a Windows PC. Now you can reinstall macOS, recover your Mac, or help someone else in trouble. If you found this video helpful, do like, subscribe, and leave a comment below if you get stuck or need any help. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.